Hello and welcome to another evening of streaming. Tonight I actually wanted to work on kind of a smaller project. It should go fairly quick. Corvus Belli, who makes Infinity, is also making Rem Racer, and it released these designs for its pilots in kind of a GB style. And I noticed that this one is very much like the Guijia Pilot, basically just the Guijia Pilot with a coat on. So I figured it'd be pretty easy to convert this. I'm not entirely sure if I want to use the Rem Racer arms, which are holding a pistol, just kind of down low at the ready. It's a nice pose, but I've kind of already have that. I've used this for another conversion before because it's a pretty stripped down model. So it's really good for conversions. So I'm not sure if I want to do another one with this same pose. And I have some other arms, or I might just modify where these arms, how these arms are set up. I might just convert them so that the gun's pistol's more pointed up. But I figured what I could do is go ahead. What I've done is I've gone ahead and shaved all the hair off so that I can do the hairstyle like this. So I think that's what I'll start with tonight, just to do something while I kind of plan out how I want to do the arms. And then the rest of it should go pretty quick. It's just, again, basically putting a coat on her, and then maybe adding a little bit more detail in the chest area here. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and mix up some green stuff. I don't want to get too much because I'm just doing the hair for tonight. Actually, a couple other things I might be able to just throw some green stuff on, so mix up a little bit more than I need for this. I think I'm going to do is do the back of the hair and the buns, and then leave the bangs and the sunglasses for another time. I think I'll also need to re-sculpt in some ears for her, because the ears used to be covered by hair, but since I've removed all that hair, she's got no ears at the moment. That's definitely a detail that, you know, it's kind of needed to make a unit model look human. Sure, I might end up leaving the ears off for right now. I think I'll probably just do the hair first. Let's think this through. So what I want to do probably is do the hair kind of in a couple layers. Two of these layers I can do tonight. And so what I want to do now is just get the flow of the hair. I guess if, you know, just the hair that's going to be underneath, and then I'll put the two buns on top and sculpt those. I think what I'm going to need is to have some things so that I can hold it without getting my fingers stuck and keep mushing her hair up. One thing I do need to be careful of is this model has very thin ankles, so I don't want to be bumping it around too much and cause these ankles to end up breaking, because then I'll have to pin it, and again, those are very thin ankles. So I think what I'll do is get hair basically in place, and I'll kind of push out where the ears will be. Approximately where the ears are going to need to be. Again, not doing the bangs, so I'm kind of cutting the hair back. Makes her look a little silly right now. She's got like a weird giant forehead. I like that she's wearing like a bonnet or something at the moment without any detail, but considering there's going to be the glasses that go on. Okay, and then I just want to get things fairly smooth so that when I put the detail on the hair, I don't have any kind of weird cross patterning or cuts, you know, that look basically like just breaks in the hair. It wouldn't look right. So you want to try and get this smooth whenever you're doing something like this before you put the detail in. And kind of true anytime you do that stunt work like this, is just make sure things are smooth, though, you know, some, depending on exactly what you're doing, you can get away with more or less smooth, but for this, it needs to be pretty smooth. And then I'm just going to go ahead and start with kind of defining where the hair is going to be parted for these buns. this is actually maybe more of a pain than it is a help. A little bit more than I want on kind of both of these sides, so I'm going to try and work it off. So I think what I'll do is just kind of make a small little dot. I want all of these to converge. So the bun's going to go here. And the bun's going to go roughly here. I think that'll get me close enough to where I need to be. Okay. Now this might be handy to have. This is a little stickier than I might want. You can see it kind of is catching to the blade and it's making it raise up a little bit. But Not too bad. Just a tad too much. This might be too much. think that'll be all right. Thanks, some of the blue. So one thing I want to try and do, as somebody who really doesn't have any hair myself, haven't for a pretty long time, I do not know how to do a bun. But I want to make sure that this looks like more than just like a blob popped on her head. One difficult thing about using water to keep your tools from sticking is that if you get too much, the water will cause a bead, and then it obscures the detail. So usually what I'll do is I'll just give a nice puff of air to blow it off, but try not to do that while on stream because it's, you know, would just be kind of loud. And probably slightly obnoxious.
Yeah.
Thanks, Emily. Yeah, if I have to do it again, I'll just puff it off. But the moment, this isn't like super fine detail as far as precision, so I'm not as worried about it. His hair is kind of messy generally anyways, unless it's like really, really, really tight braids. There's some imprecision to it, so I'm not super worried. But when I'm doing like buttons or things like that along a pants or something, that can get troublesome. Okay, so I think that's a pretty good start for the hair. I'll just need to do the bangs and the glasses. But I kind of want to get... Ooh, that's actually not great. So looking at from it from top down... I'm going to see if I can move one of these. This is probably much more than I need for the ear. So her ears might be a little bit big, but I think that's probably fine. Just want to make sure that they're spaced far enough away from her head or from her face that it doesn't look like they're coming out of her cheeks. Make sure that it's close to that jawline. I think also her ears are just going to look huge until I can put some bangs on her. Which makes them stick out extra more when there's not really any hair in front of them. This one I don't think it is. I think there's something more going on with this one. It's causing me more trouble. Alright, yeah, if you have to duck out, have a good night. I should be finishing up here pretty soon, at least with this stream. I think I'll just try and, I don't want to try and put too much detail on the ear. Probably try and clean it up with paint if I can. If I feel like there's not enough. Really kind of going for almost basically just like a, doing a little bit of a C shape here. The gesture of the ear, I guess. Rather than like a hyper detailed ear. This one, again, causing me problems though, because it's Okay. Again, I think her ears are kind of big. In fact, maybe too big, which is why I keep trying to pare them down. Okay, so I think I might add a little more detail to the ear once this is all cured. Probably next session. I think the next thing I want to do, this little pattern here got kind of disrupted because I repositioned the leg. So I want to just go ahead and kind of recreate that little hex there. And I think I'll call it a night on this figure. Thing I'm going to do. This has a knee pad on it, this side doesn't. And on the concept, as you can see, she has knee pads on both sides. So I'll just go ahead and add that knee pad. Probably bulk out the first knee pad as well. So it's fairly small, and I think it'll be easier to match if I bulk both of them out at the same time. Okay, I think those will work. I think the hair's coming along pretty good. I'm happy with where it's at right now. And this. Maybe push this one back a little bit. Just cleaned up a little bit so that where the cut is not quite so, doesn't stand out quite as much, doesn't break, just pattern doesn't end right there. And I think once it's painted, it would not show up, but I've done this mod on the same model before with the leg. I maybe didn't do it quite as clean. So I just want to make sure to try and have that as clean as possible so that when I paint it, it's not noticeable. I added some knee pads. I think the main thing I'm going to need to do is figure out what arms I want to use for her because I have two arms. Unfortunately, they don't both match. Like, this is a very similar arm, but it doesn't quite match the arm that I want to use on the other side, which is this arm. So if I use those arms, it's going to require a little bit more sculpting, so I got to kind of determine what I want to do with that, if I want to do with that, or if I just want to do the simple gun down pose, or maybe modify that slightly. But should go fairly quick. I'm thinking probably maybe two more sessions, maybe three, depending on which arms I use and maybe some other factors, but should go relatively quick. Anyways, thank you all for joining me tonight, and you have a good rest of the evening.